Hey friends, welcome to my video. Thanks for clicking on my thumbnail. Glad you're here with I Like Team. Now, today, friends, we are here because we have some news to catch up on. And it is quite a bit of news, if I'm being honest. K-pop Junkie just posted his new video, and it came out 30 minutes ago, and we have a lot to catch up on. But also, on top of all of that, I actually reacted to, but the file got corrupted, his video he put out like 3 or 4 days ago, and this is a 5-minute video. I remember looking at my video file, and it was 20 minutes long. I had a lot to say on these 5 minutes. So what we're gonna do first is we're gonna watch this video, recap everything that happened, just in case any of these stories have progressions made on them. But I'm gonna try to condense my thoughts this time. I'll try not to make it 20 minutes. I'll try to keep it around the 5 to 8 minute mark, you know, just kind of just talk about what's going on. And then we have this new video, find out more new stuff that's been going on. They're both 5 minute videos, so yeah, I hope y'all are excited. We gotta see what's going on this week, get caught up with the news and all that stuff. So yeah, before we get into it, obviously I need y'all to make sure, for me it's re-like, but go like this video to support K-pop Junkie, because he puts lots of effort into these videos and keeps us updated. Without him, I'd be lost, because I don't trust all these other news channels. They'd be clickbaiting, and I just don't care, if I'm being honest. So yeah, we're here. Nah, there's actually some other channels that are like fine. It's just there's a few that I just don't like the way they clickbait. And he always gives me reliable news, and he seems like a pretty stand-up guy, you know, so I be vibing. So we're here. But yeah, let's get into the first topic.
This all started back in May of last year when this photo came out of what people thought or think is Jennie and V together at Jeju Island. Well, eventually that rumor and discussion went away until now.
Oh,
almost exactly 1 year later, because a French photographer posted a photo of what seemed like V and Jennie holding hands taking a walk in Paris. Not only did he clarify that he posted this 2 days later for their safety, some fans even got on a video call with him to verify the validity of the recording. Well, after the initial post, people started piecing together more evidence, like members of Jennie's management, one who was seen wearing the same jacket, a clear photo of V wearing the same outfit, and now what seems like a couple necklace worn by both parties recently. Now, it turns out this video was confirmed not to be Jennie and V kissing. Instead, it's another couple that was posted on the Chinese version of TikTok back in March. Eventually, both YG and HYBE reportedly stated, "We do not know due to it being their private lives." As big as this has been in the...
So y'all be taking everything you can and trying to form a story about it. First of all, some people kissing. Oh, that's clearly them. Y'all stop reaching. Oh my God. First of all, here's what I have to say. Based on their response, a lot of times these companies will be like, "I don't know. We ain't gonna speak on that. Mind your business," you know? They don't really say it. It's like, that's their private lives. We ain't gonna speak on that, right? So take that how you will. But this time they said, we don't know due to it being regarding their private lives, right? And they didn't release the privacy. So that's what they, so like, basically, here's my consensus. BTS and Blackpink. I find it funny that they're like the two biggest groups, basically, and they have been for a long time. I don't know. There's a lot of groups that are really popular these days, but for a long time, the last few years, it's like BTS and Blackpink, and there's other groups, obviously, in K-pop, but those are like the main ones that people know about, right? And so, like, even outside of K-pop, people know who BTS and Blackpink are. So I find it funny that they're the ones that always get shipped together. It's just because they have so many fans that a lot of those fans end up bleeding over, and then you're gonna, because the fandoms are so large and because there's so many fans that are fans of both, like me personally, even though I'm a fan of a ton of K-pop groups, and they're just big fandom. There's always gonna be some people in your fandom that ship people, but then there's also people that take it way too far and they start accusing, and then there's delusional people who are like, "I can't believe you're in a relationship that was supposed to be me," and then, "Can't you just be proud of people?" Much less, they're both two of the most famous idols in the world. They both are ambassadors, I'm pretty sure, for like fashion brands and whatnot. And so it's like, are you surprised they're both in Paris? Much less they're both at like these big events, because they're big people. Like, celebrities get together all the time for events. That's a thing that happens. Oh, but we spotted them walking together, so clearly they're dating. And they had on the same jewelry. It's not like they had to do a photo shoot or... I don't know. Look, I don't really care. Much less, they're both Korean, so they're probably going to hang out together because they can speak to each other easiest. And their staff, they're probably around their staff a lot. Like, all the people that traveled with them, it's like... look, realistically, they don't know that much. Like, they know Korean. I mean, they both know English quite well. But other than that, I don't know. Do they? I don't know too much. Like, you feel me? So, like, to be hanging around, is that a problem? I don't know. Apparently, it is. You can't do that. Otherwise, you're dating. So, That's my thoughts.
We do not know due to it being
their private lives. I'm proud for them, though.
As big as this has been in the K-pop world, it's not the only thing BTS have been in the headlines for in the last day or two. A military nurse is now under fire for leaving her workstation without permission during work hours in order to visit a separate training center so that she could administer a vaccination to BTS's Jin. She apparently drove 30 minutes to where he was stationed and conspired with another medic she knew there so that she would be able to get to Jin. She would eventually administer a secondary vaccination against hemorrhagic fever for Jin and later bragged about it, saying Jin was in a lot of pain. Apparently the rules and laws she broke could lead to a year in prison and or monetary fines. Plus she's also suspected to be distributing Tylenol unauthorized. The nurse has now denied the suspicions, claiming that a request for collaborative work had come in and that she had reported it before leaving because it would be crazy of her to do so just because she wanted to. It really would. Just like it would be crazy.
W transition. Okay. Yeah, that really would be crazy. So when I remember, it was funny. Last time when I first saw this, I was sitting there and I was like, oh my, because I didn't know this story until he was talking about it. I was like, oh my goodness. Yo, that's crazy. You can't do that. But I kind of respect you for it. Now, hear me out. I was like, I kind of respect you for it. You know what? You go, as long as you, like, you broke a little rule here and there, but it was for a good cause. You wanted to meet, I mean, it's not really, like, you shouldn't do that. But, like, I wasn't that mad. Like, I was like, you shouldn't do that. Like, I'm kind of mad, but it's just kind of like, I'll overlook it. I understand a little bit, you know, sometimes, you know. But then he had his fight. He was like, then she bragged about it because he was in a lot of pain. And then I'm like, wait. You didn't do this. You did this because you wanted to. So now all of a sudden she's like the bad character who was already the bad character. But now she's like the really bad character. She was like the bad character where I was like, I low-key respect it. But like in a weird way. But now it's like, I don't even respect it. What are you doing? And then it's like, she's apparently illegally distributing Tylenol. Even, whatever. And then apparently she can face time and like have fun. I mean, have fun in I don't know about that one. I don't know if you're going to get charged or whatever, but if you do,
easy of her to do so just because she wanted to. Was it really worth
it? Like, was it that, like, come on, like, bro, was it?
Really would.
This next story is the one I talked the longest about. This is crazy.
It would be crazy of her to do so just because she wanted to. It really would. Just like it would be crazy for a tour organizer to try to scam fans and yell at the artists they're supposed to be organizing for. At last are currently or supposed to be touring in the US right now, but their first couple of stops have been disasters. On top of fans having to organize lines and everything themselves, the LA show apparently started 3 hours late, and fans would still be kicked out without getting the meet and greet, high touch, or merch they paid for. According to some fans in attendance, the event organizers, MC Entertainment, would laugh and mock fans who were trying to get answers afterward, blamed Alas for the issues, and even yelled at the guys when they asked what was going on. Now, I can't verify that except for the few clips going around.
They want to talk to their fans. Let them.
Yeah, we want to. It's their venue.
Okay. So don't kick them out.
Everything that we talked about, you're going
to do. Don't do this in front of the boys. Calm down. Calm down. The boys are right here. You do not yell in front of them.
Amazing, and we support
I know, but
them.
I love you guys, and so they're not going to kick you guys out.
No, nobody's kicking them out.
The Atlanta stop was canceled altogether.
See, now here we go. So now let's talk. I'm on two sides here. I need more perspectives and more backstory about the clip we just saw. The one clip we just saw, I'm not going to lie. That one clip we just saw, I'm on no one's side there, if I'm being honest. I saw LS back there in the background. I just assume that's them based off the, you know, outfits. It looked like attire for the artists. But she kind of sounded a little annoying. She came off kind of annoying, if I'm being honest. Like, the way she was like, hey, yo. But, like, and, like, I don't know. It's like, but then at the same time, if she is someone who has paid for a high touch, paid for, like, VIP, go backstage, get your picture taken, say hi, whatever. You can't just, like, I don't know. Maybe that's not exactly what that was. But, like, it still seems a bit crazy. Like, the whole situation is bad. Like, literally horrible. Assuming those are, like, the event organizers, like, no, we're not kicking them out, but you gotta go. No, I literally don't. Yeah, you do. Get out of here. And then she's just arguing back. Like, I kind of understand. So, like, but it picks up in the middle of an argument, so it makes neither side look good. You know how I mean? But if I knew the backstory, I'm sure I'd be on Hopefully I'm on her side. I don't know. We'd have to see. Either way, that's crazy. But then, that's bad. It gets worse.
The Atlanta stop was canceled altogether after people had already checked in. This was because of last minute safety concerns due to the poor condition of the venue. Apparently, it was a wedding venue with a stage that was definitely not made for dance performances. The chairs we see kept getting added one by one because they somehow didn't know how many tickets they sold. The guys were visibly upset, reportedly crying, and kept apologizing to the people who were there. The silver lining here is that some fans did get the meet and greet, but not the show, opposite of what happened in LA. Elast Company has now come out apologizing, announcing that these fans would get a refund from the tour agency, and the guys even promised themselves that they would come back. Now, there's not a bunch of positive news.
I don't even know what to say anymore. I went crazy last time. Okay, so get this. You saw those chairs. Now, personally, as someone who lives, I live down south. I live in Alabama. I live in Huntsville. And K-pop, if I want to go to any K-pop concerts, they're always in Atlanta, which is 4.5 hours away from me. If I drove 4.5 hours, got there, it was a wedding venue. Bro, Huntsville is the biggest city in Alabama. We got plenty of places y'all could. No one ever comes to Huntsville. One of these days, these groups are going to come to Huntsville and it's going to be lit. At least go to Nashville. That's only 2 hours away from me. It's a lot closer. Either way. That's crazy. You really thought they was gonna dance on that? Did you not know who you had coming? They thought they just had, literally, who'd you think was coming? Maybe they thought a soloist was coming or something. Like, maybe one person could maybe dance on that. Maybe, I don't. So then people pay, get in, and find out they can't. And then the organizers are sitting there like, wait, we don't even know how many people are coming. They did so little research. They didn't know. And so then their company, I mean, it's probably very slightly on the company's fault, LS's company, but not really. It's mostly on the event organizers, the actual people themselves. Because LS, they're just reaching out to this company, hey, can we work with y'all, get this tour, blah, 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 blah. And then they have some trust. That's a 50-50 thing there. And that whole side of the music industry, which touring is how a lot of these groups and companies make a lot of money. You can make decent money doing shows and whatnot. So for them to get screwed over like this, two shows in, it's so unfortunate, if I'm being honest. I'm not even an LS stan, right? They have some songs I like. I forget what it's called. It's Poison or something. Did they have a song called Poison? They had this one song a few years ago. It was really good. I liked it. But either way, my point is, y'all gotta it's so bad. For any fans that were at that Atlanta show, considering that's my local, if you will, for K-pop concerts, hey, I feel for y'all. Hey, that's crazy. At least y'all got to still have, some of y'all still got to have a fan sign. That, I guess that's pretty cool. It was probably pretty, if anything, that was probably pretty intimate. That whole concert was going to be kind of intimate because it's a really, really small venue. Y'all was going to be right next to the, if y'all, for what it's worth being. As a fan, intimate's maybe not the best word, but y'all get the point. It's going to feel very cozy. What's the best word? You know what I mean? Just one of them nice environments. You just there watching them perform. There's not too many people around you. It's not crazy. To still have a fan sign. They were signing some albums, talking face to face with some of the fans. It's that's still cool. But most people that were gonna go there had to travel, waste their gas money, and then it just never happened. And it's that's just unfortunate. So hopefully things like this stop happening as much in K-pop.
See, and the guys even promised themselves that they would come back. Now, there's not a bunch of positive news because it's only been 2 days since the last video, but there's still some really cool things to celebrate.
Let's celebrate.
First of all, how awesome is this picture? It's an unseen photo from 2009, released by SM to kick off SHINee's 15th anniversary celebrations. If this is what they start with, I don't know how I'm gonna handle the rest.
Bro, I know, bro, SHINee. Okay, no, I'm actually so hyped for a SHINee comeback, bro. Look at that.
If this is what they start with, I don't know how I'm gonna handle the rest. By the way, really quick, I teamed up with Leo Presents to give away 4 general admission tickets to Tribee's first American tour.
Sadly, I still don't see Huntsville or Nashville, but it's fine because Tribee, I really like their music, so I don't care what y'all perform. Hopefully people actually go, and good luck winning these tickets if anyone's entering.
I teamed up with Leo Presents to give away 4 general admission tickets to Tribee's first American American tour. I just thought it would be a fun thing to do with you guys. So if you're a fan, you comment your favorite song or bias, screenshot that comment, and DM me on Instagram.
And my bias is the one with the short hair. I forget her name. Y'all told me what her name was. I forget. But she's my bias.
Not a week goes by where 50-50 doesn't make history. They've now hit number 8 on the UK singles chart. Again, the first K-pop group to even secure a top 10 spot on it, and are also now tied with Blackpink and Selena Gomez's Ice Cream.
They got it already! And Blackpink and Selena Gomez,
spot on it, and are also now tied with Blackpink.